forgot my GoPro at home, so I'm shooting this on my iPhone 6. Sorry for the noise. Windows are down, hitting the highway. I ordered the rims. I'm gonna include a screenshot of the rims here. And the rims are on their way. They're being custom made, 15 by 10 with a 1-inch backspace. That equates to about a negative 108 offset like Tyler Fialco recommended to get the poke that I need. That should push the tires out about 6 to 8 inches outside of the fender wells currently. That should allow me to tack on the metal wide body kit to the width that I want. So now I'm on the Craigslist trade deal, heading to Canyon City, south of here, to buy a set of rims and tires. Then I can sell the rims to compensate for some of the cost of the tires themselves. And then we'll go see my buddy Omar to mount the tires. They're obviously gonna need a stretch. Yeah, we'll go from there. I'm on the highway now, so no more talking, just driving. Alright, so I got these big sons of bitches ready to roll. Now we head back. For anybody wondering, that's how you carry monster truck tires on a Miata. Sweet. Alright, so finally back home. It was an hour each way to Canyon City to pick these guys up, but luckily they are some spotless, no nothing, no curb rash, no marks. They're just spotless rims. So I'll probably end up getting back what I paid for the whole set on just the rims alone. There's some Goodyear Eagle Ultra Grip, so I'm super stoked. I'm probably gonna yellow letter the Goodyear part, but the tread pattern's pretty cool. I think they'll look nice stretched onto the 10-inch rims. Still waiting on those. They said a week to 10 days turnaround, and then obviously like 2 to 3 days ground shipping to get to me. So I'm waiting on those right now, but just super exhausted. It was like 82 degrees. Having the trunk up like that was like the worst ever for gas mileage. So it took like a quarter of a tank of gas to do something that should have took an eighth. But I'm back, got the rims and tires unloaded. Now I'm just waiting on the shipment to arrive. So just a quick little update, let you guys know what I'm doing so that you can see the process along the way. And then obviously once the rims come, I can get the tires blasted onto them. Unfortunately, I just found out my guy Omar is having some trouble with the landlord. So it's the only guy I know in town that has a Cheetah. I mean, I'm sure there's another guy, but I don't know of him. So I'm going to have to find another dude with a Cheetah to get these tires blasted and stretched onto the 10 inch. And then I can mount those on. They should stick out to, I'd say like probably here. And then I can tack on the metal wide body, and that's going to be a whole nother episode. Hopefully you guys like that. Going to be like some little side skirts that I got to build for where the fender ends at the bottom. And then there'll be like a step out kind of box. So the door will be recessed into not only the back fender, but the front fender and this little side box here. And then I believe I'm going to run a 2 1/4 inch straight pipe down to right about there. And then it's going to tee off and come out on both sides. So exhaust here and an exhaust on the other side in the same spot right behind the door. So that's going to be kind of cool. I'm real excited for that. I really like the idea. I've drawn it out in my head and on paper once. I can't find the paper, but that's the plan. The front fenders, I think I'm just going to take a strip of metal and tack it in here, like cut right here, and then tack that metal in between there and there so it brings the fender out to here. And I'm thinking about cutting the fender here and having some of those adjustable standoff splitter stanchions, maybe even all thread rod. I don't know how ghetto or how professional I want to go with it, but the fender is literally going to stick out about, say, 4 to 6 inches, and then there'll be mesh in here to keep anything from getting stuck in there. And same thing in the back, there'll be a fender way out here with an open hole, and then that hole is gonna have mesh in it. And then down here on the front, the side panel that's kind of like side kick box or foot jam, whatever it's called, it's gonna have an angled back piece with some mesh going into it so that it blows down and cools the exhaust tip itself, keeping it from causing any heat warpage on the metal. Whatever, I don't know. It's all just gonna be for looks, really, but I think it's gonna look pretty cool. Kind of like a GTA, what is it called, the Banshee. So technically gonna make a Miata Banshee. Just gotta get the rims and tires done, and then I'll know how far out to put the metal. So stay tuned, like if you liked, subscribe if you want, and as always, guys, keep modding.